Dear students, we are in the third chapter. The name of the chapter is Nouns. As usual, based on your previous knowledge, what is a noun? What are its roles? Let's do the warm-up exercises. First and foremost, let us read the definition of a noun. Nouns are the names of people, places, animals, things, ideas, and feelings. Once again, names of people, places, animals, things, ideas, and feelings. The first one, fill in the blanks with the suitable nouns. The first one has been done for you. Rest you can do as a homework. Dash played with a dash. Tom played with a ball. The dash said, "I respect your dash." The teacher said, "I respect your decision." You can make your own sentences. No worry, no problem. Dash baked a delicious dash yesterday. My mother baked a delicious cake yesterday. The pink dash has many dash. The pink dress has many flowers. So in this way, the following exercises, please do as the homework. Now we are going to deal various kinds of nouns. As given in the books, there are four kinds of nouns. They are known as proper nouns, common nouns, collective nouns, and abstract nouns. Let's begin with one by one. Proper nouns. These are the names of specific people. I have highlighted the word specific. And they always begin with a capital letter. Specific people like Ahmed, Ratha, Delhi, Tufi, Willy, the specific ocean, the Ganga, the Ramayana, and the times of India. Remember, they always begin with a capital letter. Next, common nouns. These two are the names of people, places, animals, things in general. There it was specific, here it is general. For example, boy, girl, man, woman, river, sea, bird, mountain, book, pen, field, garden, road. These are the examples of common nouns. Some examples of common nouns. Next kind of noun is known as collective nouns. These are a collection or a group of people, animals, or things. A collection or a group of people, animals, or things. For example, an army of soldiers, a bunch of keys, a bundle of sticks, a fleet or ships, a collection or a group of people, animal, or things. Next kind of noun is known as abstract nouns. These nouns denote an idea, a quality, or a state of being. The examples are beauty, strength, love, hatred, greed, bravery, length, heat. These are known as these examples contains an idea, a quality, or a state of being. These are known as abstract, not concrete. Now we have few exercises. Let us do. I have given the answers of these exercises after 2-3 slides. Let's do one by one. You can do them in your notebook. These are the exercises. Ramesh saw a swarm of locusts and ran to safety. In this, Ramesh is the proper noun. Locust is the common noun. And swarm is the collective noun. And safety is the abstract noun. Next. Mala pushed her way through a herd of cows. In this, Mala is a proper noun. Cows is a common noun. Herd is collective noun. Third, the crew of the ship was injured in the accident. In this sentence, there is no proper noun. Ship and accident. Ship is the common noun. Crew is the collective noun. Accident is the abstract noun. Again, ship is the common noun. Crew is the collective noun. Accident is the abstract noun. Arunima picked a bunch of grapes for me after much persuasion. In this sentence, Arunima is the proper noun. Grapes is a common noun. Bunch is a collective noun. Persuasion is the abstract noun. Fifth, the lady there has a fleet of luxurious ships. In this sentence, we have the lady as the common noun, ships as the common noun, fleet is the collective noun. So once again, the answers of these exercises are given in after 2 slides. Let us see what has been given there. As per that, kindly do it in your notebook. So far we have completed the up to 5th one. You can read the rest of them and find out, understand it for yourself. Answers are given after 2 slides. As I told you, the 5th one, lady, ships, and fleet. So once again, if you let us read through one by one, that will be better. We have reached up to fifth one. Rajiv faced a pack of ferocious hounds with courage on Sunday. In this, Rajiv and Sunday are the common noun. Hounds is the common noun. Once again, Rajiv and Sunday are the proper noun. Hounds is the common noun. Pack is the collective noun. And courage is the abstract noun. Mohini decided to adopt a puppy from the litter. Mohini is the proper noun. Puppy is the common noun. Litter is the collective noun. Meena squealed with delight when she saw a school of dolphins. In this sentence, Meena is the proper noun. Dolphin is a common noun. School is a collective noun. Delight is the abstract noun. Next, the troupe of singers stayed in a hotel which is known for its hospitality. Again, the troupe of singers stayed in a hotel which is known for its hospitality. In this sentence, singers and hotel are the common noun. Troupe is the collective noun and hospitality is the abstract noun. 10th one. All my friends in the class took part in games and sports with sincerity. In this, friends, games, and sports are the common noun. Class is the collective noun. And sincerity is the abstract noun. So, the examples to the previous exercises I have given here. Kindly, if you have any doubt, kindly go through. Now, in your textbook, we have certain exercises, page number 13. Find 15 collective nouns in the word grid and use them to complete the given sentences. I have not given that exercise here, only I have given the answers that on page number 13 in your textbook that you have to see the PDF and see the questions, how it is being given there. I have given you only the answers here. These are the, we have to find out the collective nouns from that columns. We read the answers. Collective nouns. We saw a mob of kangaroos in the zoo. So mob of kangaroo is the collective noun. A pod of dolphins. The board of directors. Collection of stamps. Constellation of stars. A flock of sheep. A troop of baboons. Archipelago of islands. a class of mats, the army of soldiers. So these are the collective nouns. We can't say a group of soldiers, a flock of soldiers, you know, an army of soldiers, a flock of sheep. The troop of dancers. Quiver of arrows. String of pearls. Range of mountains. A bunch of bananas. Now, we have certain words here to form abstract nouns. If we add, use suitable suffixes to form abstract nouns of these words. In some cases, the words will change completely. It is in the page 14. If we add some words to these words, it becomes, we can form the abstract nouns. Just, I-C-E, it becomes, justice becomes an abstract noun. Hate, hatred. I hate, it becomes hatred. Child, childhood. Kind, kindness. Generous, generosity. Stupid, stupidity. Move, movement. Good, goodness. Poor, poorness. Brave, braveness. Calm, calmness. Slave, slavery. True, truth. Believe, believable. Confuse, confusion. Dishonest, dishonesty. Resist, resistance. Bore, boredom. Mimic, mimicry. Possess, possession. So, in this, we have formed abstract nouns by adding certain words after the particular word. Now, next group of exercises are known as number. Here we are going to deal with the countable nouns and uncountable nouns. We have told you earlier, there are four kinds of nouns: proper nouns, common nouns, abstract nouns, and collective nouns. Now we are going to deal with countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Some nouns can be counted while others cannot be counted. Nouns that cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. For example, water, soil, bravery, honesty, iron, grass, butter, sugar. They do not have a plural form. We cannot make it as a plural form. Nouns that can be counted are called countable nouns. Table, boy, tree, mango, bat, pan, building. Most countable nouns have a singular and plural form. Uncountable nouns cannot have a plural form, but countable nouns may have its plural form too. Now, a noun that denotes one person or thing is said to be in the singular number. For example, flower, cow, house, sister, garden. A noun is in the plural number if it denotes more than one person or thing. So here we are speaking about singular number nouns and plural number nouns. A noun is in the plural number if it denotes more than one person or thing. Simple as that. For example, flowers, cows, houses, sisters, garden. Now, a note there is, we can make uncountable nouns countable by adding partial nouns. We can make uncountable nouns by adding partial nouns. Now, for example, chocolate. If we add a bar of chocolate, it becomes the countable noun. 4 pieces of furniture, a tub of butter, a spoon of sugar. In these sentences, they were uncountable nouns, but by adding these partial nouns, by adding certain words, it becomes the partial nouns and it can be counted. A bar of, 4 pieces, a tub of butter, a spoon of sugar. Now there are certain rules to make the nouns or certain words to its plural, the plural form of the words. There are few rules in the textbook. Let us read by one by one. Let us try to understand them. How we make a particular word into plural. Type. Most nouns. We can make the plural form of the most nouns by adding just S. See, rule. Just add S to make its plural form. Pen, pens. Next. Nouns ending in S, S, Sha, Kha, Ts. Sorry, it is Cha, church. First one, S, bus, S, dress, Sh, brush, church, ch, cha, it's box. Now we see in these sentences, if the nouns are ending with these pronunciation, these words, we add just es in order to make its plural form. First one, bus, buses, we just added es. Dress, dresses. Brush, brushes. Church, churches. Box, boxes. In order to make the plural form of these words, we have added just es. The nouns are ending with these words, s, double s, sh, ch, x. We just add es to make the plural form of the verb. Next, nouns ending in a consonant followed by O. Now, again, nouns ending in a consonant followed by O. What happens there? We add ES. Now you see the examples, tomato. In this before O, there is a consonant, T. Here too, before O, there is a consonant, R. So here, in order to make the plural form of this verb, these nouns, we add just ES. Tomato, tomatoes. Hero, heroes. Nouns ending in a vowel followed by O. Here we dealt nouns before O, there is a consonant, T-R. So we added ES. Here we have a vowel ratio. I, ratio, radio. Here before O, there is a vowel. There we had a consonant. Therefore, we added ES to make the plural form of the noun. Here we have a vowel. When we have a vowel before O, we just add S in order to make the plural form of the noun. There we added ES. Here we add only S. Ratio, ratios. Radio, radios. Now next, nouns ending in a consonant followed by Y. City. Before Y, there is a consonant T, Y, S. So how can we make the plural form of these nouns? The rule says change Y to I and add ES. If the nouns that are ending with Y and if the particular noun has got a consonant before Y, in order to make the plural form of the noun, what we need to is we need to change the Y to I and add ES. The first one, city, cities. Here, Y we removed, added I, and also added ES in order to make the plural form of this noun. Daisies, remove the I, remove the Y, add I and add ES. So we get the plural form of this noun. Nouns ending in a vowel followed by Y. Monkey, play. Before Y, there is a vowel, E-A. So in order to make the plural form of it, we just add S, monkeys, plays. Nouns ending in F or F-E. So in order to make the plural form of the nouns that are ending in F or F-E, what we need to do is, we need to change the F, the letter F or F-E to V and add ES. Again, the words, the nouns that are ending with F or F-E, we need to change the letter F or F-E to V and add ES in order to make the plural form. Or add S. First one, dwarf, scarf, knife, thief. See here, two ways we can do. First one, dwarves, D-W-A-R-V-S. What we have done, we have removed F or F, F removed and added V and ES, dwarves. Or we can just add S, dwarf, add this S and we can make the plural form. Otherwise, dwarves, D-W-A-R, remove F, add V and ES. Scarf, first one, scarves or scarves, removed F, added V and ES. Knives, here only we cannot add S, but rather we removed F-E and added V-E-S. Thieves, T-H-I-V-E-S. Now certain exceptions. Man, goose, foot. Some nouns undergo a vowel change. In order to make the plural form of these nouns, only a certain vowel change is enough to make the plural form. See, men, man, men. We removed A and added E. Goose, geese, foot, feet. It just undergo a vowel change. Now, more exceptions. Here, certain nouns do not change in plural form also, the word remained the same. Salmon, deer, jewelry, information. We don't say, in order to make the plural form of these words, we do not add S or ES. The words are the same. Most of the time we make these kind of mistakes. Salmon, deer. We don't say deers, jewelries, no. Informations, no. Information, not S. We don't add S, informations. We say only information. Kindly keep in mind. Now, unchanging. There are certain words exist in the plural form itself. See, odds, trousers, pliers, tweezers exist only in the plural form. We need not to add or edit anything. Now we have here certain proper words how to write in plural forms. Most of the time we make these kind of mistakes. These exercises are given on page 16. These are the right way of writing the plurals. Tools. No, it is not that way. It is teeth. Curries. C-U-R-R-I-E-S. Fries. The right way of plural is F-R-I-E-S. Canvases. Oxen. Journeys. Mice. Species. Salmon. Scissors, bakeries, scarves, geese, person. See, we always persons. No, never say plural form of the person is person only, not persons. Essays, E-Y-S. Now we have another set of exercises on page 16 itself. In these sentences, there are few errors. We need to find out which are those errors. Now, I am going to buy some new furnitures. In this sentence, as I told you earlier, in the note it is given, the plural form of the furnitures, no, it is a just only furniture. I am going to buy some new furniture. Ask your parents' advices. Now, the plural form of the advice, not advices, it is advice. Sheep are grazing in the fields. It is not a collective noun of sheep. It is not a sheep. It is sheep are grazing in the field. I saw it on the news. The plural form of the noun news is not a N-U-N-E-W-E-S. It is N-E-W-S. They had good weathers on the trip. Again, the usual mistake that we do, we add weathers. It is not a weathers, it is just a weather. They had good weather on their trip. We won the match by an inning. No, it is, we have to say, we won the match by an innings. She is suffering from measles. She is suffering from measles. He denied all knowledges about the incident. What the wrong in this sentence? It is knowledge, not knowledges. He denied all knowledge about the incident. TV is a means of communications. No, TV is a means of communication. I'll not comment until I have collected all the information. Not informations. Plural form of the noun is information, not informations. Keep in mind. So here we end The first session, first video of the chapter, the following will continue in the next video. So thanks for watching it. Kindly do the exercises.